Welcome to our new grammar lesson on subject-verb agreement. By the end of the session, you should be able to So let's look at these sentences and choose which one is correct. The first group, the girl sing, and here the girl sings. Which one is correct? It's the second one. And why? Because the verb with an S agrees with the singular noun. Here the tree grow, or the tree grows. Of course, the second one is correct because this is a singular noun, and the verb that agrees with the singular noun is the verb with an S. So the subject and verb in a sentence must agree or work together. How would they work together? If the subject is singular, the verb must be singular. If the subject is plural, the verb also must be plural. Singular subject, you need a singular verb. A plural subject, you need a plural verb. We have to focus very, very carefully on how to form these plural and singular and how to distinguish between them. So what are the rules for these rules are for verbs that tell about the present time. So we are talking about the present time. Okay, so if the subject is a singular noun, or he, she, or it, these are pronouns. He, she, it are pronouns, singular pronouns. Yes. They are singular pronouns, okay? Or if we have a noun, so what do we do to the verb? We add S or ES to the verb according to what are the letters at the end of the verb. For example, this is the first example here. The star shines. Star is singular, so singular means that we add S to the verb shines. Now let's look at these other two examples. The girl looks at the star. The girl is singular, so we add S to the verb to make it also singular. Okay, she, here this is the pronoun. Also this pronoun is singular, so we add singular pronoun, so we add S to the verb to make it also singular. If the subject is compound, what is the meaning of compound? It means I use and in the subject, like what? Like my mom and I, or Ahmed and his brother, or Sarah and Lamar. So I'm using and. This is a compound subject, okay? Or a plural noun. So if it is compound subject or plural noun, or I. This is I, you, we, or they. These are the plural pronouns. And I, of course, we don't add S to the verb if the subject is I. Okay? We don't add S or ES. We don't add any S's to the verb. Do not. So if we have the stars shine, the stars. What is this noun? It's a plural noun, so we don't add S to the verb. Okay, Sarah and Rainy look at the stars. Sarah and Rainy, this is a compound subject. Compound subjects are plural because I have two here, two subjects, so I don't add S to the verb. Okay, they smile. They is a plural pronoun. I write here P because it's plural. There, you can look at it to make it just easier for you. If you write above the subject S, so add S to the verb. If you write P, so don't add, there is no S. Okay, it makes it easier for you to remember when to add the S. Now let's look at verb to be. Okay, use am with I, of course, and yes, and is to agree with singular subjects. Okay, so use am and is to agree with singular subjects, and are to agree with plural, are to agree with plural subjects. For example, this is the first example here. Yes, the scientists, plural, so use are. The scientists are here. The pilots also plural, use are with a plural. Okay, I, we use with it am. I am a space traveler. The astronaut here is singular, we use with it is. Okay, the scientists plural, we use are here. The pilots are on the plane, the same. So here only to remember, refreshment of your memory. Here I am, you are, he, she, it, or names, is, we, you, they, are, and of course here this is a compound noun, Jim and Anne, or the cities, plural. This is in the past. Our lesson is focused on the present. The lesson. Okay, so this is, I think this is the new part of the lesson in grade 6, the collective nouns. What is the meaning of collective noun? A collective noun means group, such as family, team, and class. If I say family, is it only one? No, it's a group of people. But family here is, it doesn't have an S. So we call it a collective noun. A collective noun is singular if it refers to a group acting as one. So it could be singular and it could be plural. We look at the action in the sentence. If the group is doing the same action, so it's a singular. If the group is doing different actions, so we use the collective noun as plural. The class is learning about the universe. Here the class is learning because everyone in the class is learning the same lesson about the universe. What if the collective noun is plural? If it refers to members of the group acting individually. Individually means everyone acts in a different way. Like what? The class are, see here, the class are disagreeing about the size of the Milky Way. So everyone here has his own opinion. They disagree. So the members of the class, the students in the class, are acting in differently. Everyone acts or has his own opinion. So they disagree. We use it as a collective noun, as a plural collective noun. We use or, and we use the verb in the plural form. These are some collective nouns. Yes. A team of players, class of students, school, students and teacher, legislature, a collection of representatives, committee, members, herd of cows or goats or sheep, flock of birds, swarm of bees, and jury of judges. Write yes as the subject and the verb agree, and write no if you do not agree, and correct and write the right form. Okay, so let's look at the first one, the science lessons. So I'm talking here about the lessons, and lessons are plural. In degrees, students. Integrate means interests or arouse the interests of the students. Here, it's plural. Should I add an S? No, wrong. So, I should know and write the correct form, intrigue. Number two, space travelers realize the risks. Okay, so this is the verb, realize. And here, travelers. This is the subject, travelers, plural. Do I see any S's here? Do I write S? No. So it's true, correct. Yes. Passengers, this is the subject, plural. Sometimes this is an adverb. Don't look at it. Waits, this is the verb. Did I write S here? Is it singular to write S to the verb? No, so this is wrong. It should be wait. Okay, Jordan, what is Jordan? A name of a boy or a man, so it's a singular one. Okay, is. Now, for example, I can replace it with he. What do I use with he? He is. Yes, so it's correct. Her eyes here, plural. Eyes is, if I change her eyes with a pronoun, it's gonna be they. They is, can I say they is? No, so it's wrong. They are. No, and are. Yes, sorry. Underline the verb in parentheses that agrees with the subject. Their heads, plural. Do I add S? No. So it's throb from the enormous pressure. Throb means to move or have impulses or pulses. Derek is the name of a man or a boy. So it's singular. I can change it with he. He are or is? He is. Derek is. Oh, sorry. Okay, the stewardess. Stewardess means someone in a ship or an airplane who helps people with the drinks and everything they need in the ship. The stewardess, volunteers or volunteer. Stewardess is singular. So I add S to the verb. Oh, so it's volunteers to get them a wheelchair. Rainy and Eric. This is a compound. I use and here, so it's compound subject. Compound subjects are plural. So do I add S? Do I see an S here? No. So what do I choose the verb with? No S, the plural verb. The landscape. Landscape, what is it? Singular. Oh yeah. Enthrall or enthralls. Singulars? S, so I choose the verb with the S, enthralls. Thank you so much. If you have any questions, you know where to post them.